so this is Roberto Sierra's Cinco Bocetos. What that means is five sketches, and this is the second sketch, which is called Canción del Campo. That means field song. And my favorite marking in this piece of music is what's written at the very beginning, with grace and a certain naivete. So this sets up a scene. If you can imagine, sort of, it's a Spanish piece, it's in a field, you can picture whoever and whatever you want to picture in there. You want to approach this with not a lot of pretense. Okay, that's the sort of general vibe of this movement, this field song. Now, what's interesting about this particular movement is that there is no meter written. It's not in 4/4 or in 6/8 or anything. It's written entirely without a meter. Now, you have two choices when you have pieces without meter. You can either play them completely unmetrically, so there's nothing rhythmic for you or for your audience to hang on. It's just kind of free-flowing music, and that's appropriate for some things. But for this piece, it's not. And I chose to give this piece a meter. Now, that meter changes, and here's where I'll show you in the very beginning. The audience does not know any of this. So what you're doing is you're kind of setting up this naive, kind of lilting, you know, like a compound meter, because it's written sort of in triplets. But here. So that could be like a measure of 6/8, and then two measures of 5/8. So that's how I kind of choose to play it. I like to make it kind of like it's a little bit drunk, or it's like stumbly, or the ground is uneven underneath your listener's ears, so to speak. Okay, so that's the setup. 16 notes sets up the entire vibe of this movement. Now, we get into the second part, you know, right away, which is the melody. Now, here Roberto Sierra does something kind of interesting. He makes it polyphonic. Now, what does that mean? Let's go back to Bach. Bach wrote a lot of polyphonic music, especially the cello suites and the violin partitas and those sorts of sonatas and things like that. What that means is that you're hearing more than one musical line happening at a time. Poly, many, phonic. Music, sounds. So polyphonic music is music that splits itself from one line into two, and you're kind of playing two melodies at once. Roberto Sierra does this here. Now, what he's done is he actually makes it as though there's a bass line, and he writes the low register, the low E, the lowest note on the clarinet, with a staccato and a little bit of an accent. Now, that doesn't mean, okay, because we're still in mezzo piano here, and it's very delicate. But what that kind of, to me, I interpret that as being kind of like a fat pizzicato finger on a bass. So, boom, 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 not boo, boo, or ka, or heh, or eh, but boo. So, again, this is naive, so boo seems sort of appropriate. And then you have the top line, which is just this beautiful sort of meandering, sort of Spanish, Latin-sounding line. How do you practice something like this, okay? Because if you just sort of played it without any demarcation of the two lines, it would still sound like music, just wouldn't be interesting as much. It's not terrible, but it doesn't have the structure that we want to give it. So I'm going to practice this. This is how I actually practice this, is I'm just going to play the melody line by itself. It's written dolce, so sweetly. It's mezzo piano, but I'm going to play this a little bit quieter, on the quieter side of mezzo piano. And I'm going to play it in time, as though this is my meter. That's my 100 beats per minute. Now I practice the bass line, again, in time. Line, the low notes, a little bit funkier, maybe a little bit louder, and I'm going to make sure that the top line immediately is quiet, so it really sounds like two lines. It's not da 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 da, but da 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 ba da da ba da, like that. Okay, so that's the general structure of this piece. There's no meter, but we put meter in it. There's two lines that we need to bring out. Sometimes it's just the bottom line, sometimes it's just the top, but more often than not, it's both of them together, and you need to separate those out. Lastly, though, and most importantly, there is not one dynamic written in this movement louder than mezzo piano. So that means this whole thing is incredibly delicate. So how do you do something that's this delicate, that has all of that stuff going on with the two lines, etc., without totally clenching your butt cheeks and feeling really pinched and having the sound be kind of like, you know? No, you don't want that. So here's the secret to that. You blow like you are playing forte, okay? So you support with your abdomen. How do we kind of activate our abdomen, which activates our diaphragm to support our lungs and our sound? Well, it's kind of, again, I've talked about this before, but it's kind of like doing a sit-up halfway. To activate your abdomen as though you were playing loudly. So. But then when you play quietly, you keep the same feeling in your abdomens. All you're doing is you're keeping the same kind of air support, but you're just blowing less air through the clarinet. Now, if you were to play this in bite, it would sound. And if you were to play this without supporting, it would sound really weak. Supported. You hear a lot of undertones and there's not a lot of sound. It's kind of half sound, half air. That's kind of how you know you're not supporting. Okay, so playing this really quietly but keeping yourself really supporting your sound and supporting your air is crucial to getting the sound you want, being able to do all of this delicate stuff, keeping it quiet. Okay, so I hope this was helpful. Again, this is Roberto Sierra. This is Roberto Sierra's Cinco Bocetos, Five Sketches, a terrific piece for solo clarinet. There's a link down in the whatever, so you can pick that up yourself. And again, hope this was helpful. Talk to you next time. See ya.